the injuries, the tolerance you had for pain must have been extraordinary, but how do you view physical pain?
See, the strongest thing a person has is his mind. And it's just, it's a mindset deal. No matter how bad you was hurt, your job was to get in that race car and do the best you could with it. So between the obligations you had to you and your family and the people that you worked with and your mind, you just went and done it. You didn't think anything about it. If you had a broke leg, you got in the car. If your ribs were broke, you got in the car. If your neck was broke, you got in the car. You know, shoulder broke, they taped the dang thing up and put you in the car and you went. And you never thought about not doing it because that was your job.
The worst rib injury you ever drove with would be what?
Well, just when they tear all your ribs loose and when the whole thing comes loose. There's nothing that I ever had hurt me as much as having broke ribs because if you breathe, they hurt. If you laugh, they kill you. And you'll be sitting here and they hurt a little bit and every time you move, they hurt more. And I get, to me, that's the worst pain I've ever had, trying to wait for them to get healed back up or kind of hook up.
How was it to drive with?
It was tough. I broke them so many times, we finally just took a piece of aluminum and went from here around to here and just bent the thing, just where it fit the ribs. And then we put foam rubber on the inside of that. And then when I get in the car, they put that on and then just tape the thing up so that when went in the corner, you had something in the seat to keep you from falling out of the seat. And so what happened when you did that, it spread it over a big period. It spread it from the top of your arm, bottom of your arm to your hip, then it didn't really push on your ribs.
Okay.
So you was able to do that without suffering too much.
Anyway. It lessened some of the pain as best it could.
Again, you know, might take a goodies or a shot of Novocaine, but they wouldn't last very long, so you just had to go on.
Explain the situation in which you broke your neck.
We was Pocono, Pennsylvania in 1980, I think, somewhere right along there. I'm going in the turn and the wheel breaks and I run up on the guardrail and a catch fence and turn the car over and just tear it all to pieces. And Dale Inman, the crew chief, he runs down there and wants to know what's going on. I said, I think I broke my neck, but don't know. Okay, so they take me over to...
You said it casually like that?
Yeah, you just said, you know, my neck's hurting, I think I broke it. I said, okay. So they laid me down, they took me to the little hospital down somewhere there in Pennsylvania. And so I'm laying there and my wife's there and we're sort of waiting on the doctor to come in. He comes in with his x-ray and he's looking at the lights and looking at it and he said, when did you have your neck broke before? I said, I didn't know I had it broke before. And he showed the x-ray where it moved over about an eighth of an inch, one of the vertebrae or something, had a crack in it and had calcium around it. And I said, well, probably broke it sometime when I broke something else and it hurt worse. See, your body can only hurt one place at a time. So, you know, then we went from there to Talladega the next week and had a doctor up there in Pennsylvania. He made me a special brace for my neck. And so we went down, I think we qualified the car and started the race. And then I got out of the car and put another boy in it. But that's what we done.
How many concussions do you think you've had?
You know, yeah, no, there's no telling. See, every time you hit your head, you got some kind of concussion. So you can imagine with all the stuff we had, you probably had 8 of 10 that was pretty strong.
You think you have any lasting side effects from the concussions?
I told the guys, I said, probably I'm walking around now with a concussion and don't even know it. Had so many so I don't know how I'd be if you didn't have a concussion. But yeah, you know it's got a beat on your head and slow down something. So I don't know if Alzheimer's or something like that, if that would have a startup deal on that, I don't know. So far I can remember to get up and eat and go to bed, so I'm okay.
For more clips from this interview, visit GrahamBensinger.com.